it's a darker roast, but it's like smooth. I like the midnight that we have here, but
Every
AOC, I feel like just has like, more of like a flavor in the meal.
Okay.
I feel like for a dark roast, it's pretty smooth. So.
Okay. What do you do for fun?
Fun-wise, I mean, my thing is like be outside and go jog. Like,
okay.
My fun, that's my food.
Right, you're a runner.
I enjoy it. I enjoy being outside, weather, you know, beautiful weather, nice job.
Okay. Very cool. Yeah. Get your brain. I feel like it, clears your mind and gets you really focused.
Thinking,
on.
But then also like just enjoying being outside, especially after a winter.
Right.
Like yesterday, I went jogging and it was crisp out, but I was like, oh, it's still nice. It's sunny out.
Yeah. Yeah. So tell us how long you've owned Sweetwaters.
We are going on year 3 of Sweetwaters. November will be 3 years. As you know, we opened up during a wacky time, a couple months into it.
Yeah.
Pandemic hit, so it's been quite a ride, you know.
Okay.
But, you know, a lot of things we've got, a lot of lessons we've been learned, a lot of experiences, things that, you know, I've never experienced if this didn't happen. So I think it made me a little more, I was always a planner, and can't plan anymore in this world. So I think it was a good thing for me, though, because I used to drive myself crazy that if things didn't go according to the plan, drive me nuts, or I'd, you know, mess up my own thing, where sort of going with the flow has definitely been a new thing for me. So.
That's very cool. I love that you've you found a benefit out of this pandemic.
Yes, again, I've been fortunate that everything sort of, is, you know, the store stayed open during the pandemic.
Yeah.
Our drive-through wound up, you know, taking off because it was only drive-through or takeout, you know. So that started, you know, picking up there.
Yeah, you guys served a lot of people too. I remember you were bringing boxes of coffee to the hospitals
and cold brew bottles to the hospitals, trying to the DDI houses, the autism, the kids over there, they were run for a bigger loop than I feel like any of us. They were used to more of a planned regimen, and now they're told that they can't go out and do anything, and the staff is, you know, going through it. So, you know, being aware of what everybody's scenario during this has gone through the
I think instead of thinking like, oh no, what am I gonna do?
Yeah.
It's okay, how can I help other people get past
for sure
this point or thing, you know?
Just to acknowledge too that we understand and we appreciate, you know, I think the frontline workers, everybody that, you know, they were going to work every single day during the biggest part of the pandemic.
Yeah.
You know? And just showing a little appreciation and thank you. We get it. You're going home, and now you have like, you know, healthcare workers and everybody like being exposed to it all day long. Now they have to go home and expose their families. You know. So that wasn't an easy thing. You know. So I think we were just so appreciative of just the community support as well. That. And that's what we're always going to be about, this community, but this just made us really like...
Gave you opportunity
just
to really prove it. Yeah.
Like I said, the community's been awesome to us. We, we have a lot of regulars that we thoroughly look forward to, you know, like it's you know, people we're seeing every single day. And now we start asking them how their families are doing or what they were doing, you know, they were going away, and, you know.
Yeah.
And I think the staff actually really appreciates that too, because it gives you that sort of, you know, that cafe feeling.
Yeah, because you think anybody wants a sense of belonging.
Yeah.
They want to belong to something or feel that somebody, and a sense of acknowledgement too.
Yeah.
Yeah, the person recognizes. Yeah. It gives people a good, warm, encouraging feeling.
And it's funny because it was never drilled into the staff that that's what you have to do, and I feel like the staff really just took it on their own to really learn the guests and really make their day. That's the
right.
first thing. And yeah. I get so many compliments through our apps and messaging and, you know, the social media platforms of how great the staff is. I've been blessed with that. That's been something that they took on. So.
Yeah, I know. When I come in and I order, like I'll order for my wife, I'll be like, oh yeah, can you make my wife's drink?
Because you'll mess it up.
Because I don't know what it is.
And I got Laura today. I got her today saying, you getting something for Jim? And she's like, oh yeah, I forgot yesterday. So cool. So we enjoy it. And it makes us thoroughly enjoy it.
What's your day like operating a full-blown coffee shop?
So, you know, as the weeks and days go on, things are just constantly different. You know, we, from the seasons, from winter, the holiday season, summertime. So, trying to adapt to all these different, it's like a roller coaster.
Ebbs and flows.
Yeah, so, and I think the world is still in a weird spot where people aren't in a pattern. So, that throws everything for a loop, but for the most part, we have a pretty well-oiled machine going on right now. We have, we start our morning with a team leader and a barista, and they're here cranking out the coffees, brewing, getting things going, the food prepped, and then, another person comes in to help just support the staff throughout the afternoon, and then I'll switch in the shifts. Closing down and making sure everything looks good for the next day. So that's pretty much the day-to-day stuff, but there's a lot more to it of marketing and social media, ordering everything, so that's more on my part.
Okay.
Where just making sure that, supply chains right now, we're having issues still. That's been our biggest struggle, this whole thing, is the supply chain of getting product and, certain branded cups. And making sure that we're not running out. If we run out, what are we doing? So those are the things that are causing more of the challenges with everything. Certain food products that we normally carry, we're having issues getting. So, having my staff explain to the guests that when they're looking at the menu to offer something else or give them another option.
Okay.
And then trying to figure out like the little fun little things that we could do to engage the guests, So for like Valentine's Day, we did a count how many hearts are in the jar. We actually gave away two prizes. They were the closest. They didn't get it on the head, but so we gave a free coffee and a pastry to those guests.
Yep.
Little things, interacting with the artwork that's
in
the cafe.
You're constantly
that developed really on its own again during the pandemic. We had a gallery in here. The gallery wound up having to close down, and I had to start giving back all the artwork. And people just started asking about the artwork, so I just said, bring in stuff, let's see what we got. And it sort of took off. Every single piece on here is a local artist, including the chalk wall behind us. And the gentleman that did this was able to sell a couple of his pieces, so it's been fun. We actually just sold another piece this last week. Another local photographer was able to sell a piece. So it's been fun to see that, I think a lot of people like to express themselves through art, and we watch the guests that were looking at coffees walk around, check out the different artwork, and that's when they actually ask, how can I get my piece of work up there? So it's been fun. And it decorates the cafe really nice. We get a lot of compliments on that.
Okay.
Yes.
What's your next, I know you did a couple of outside events.
So right now, we're hoping right now, we're going to work with Nextdoor, to do a sort of a spring event, so maybe April, not our full one. We've got a little chilly, so we're going to try to focus more bringing it towards the front. We might actually even incorporate, adapt the pet. There's a woman, Lisa, that works at the wine guy next door. She's big in animal rescue and things like that. So we can link up and do something like that, because I think everybody loves that. It'd be fun. It's something different. Plus spring, I think it's going to be fun to have people out again.
Yeah.
That I think that's, things are starting to look better, so I think people just want to get out, enjoy the nice weather, so I feel like that would be good, a fun little event, bring some more local vendors, that we did in the past, just to highlight other businesses as well. So I think that was another big thing that we learned through this whole thing is to, we were supported by so many other people and businesses that supporting them as well is huge, and I think the community actually loves to see that.
When you're doing other local things and joint, community events, it's really, I think it brings everybody together.
And when we talk about, I'm from Port Jeff, so I never came to Smithtown until we opened up the cafe. But to see how this town is and how, again, how supportive they've been, how they want to see. I remember a woman at the drive-thru, she's like, I'm going to do everything I can to keep your doors open. Just please try to stay open. I said, I'll do my best. And she showed up almost every single day. She still comes. She's a regular guest.
Yeah.
But, it's cool to see that, people want to see a business like this in their town. They want to see it, do well. So.
I think one thing I have to say for Smithtown and the surrounding area is people really rally for other people.
Yes.
In general, if there's a cause or something going on, people really rally for each other.
Oh, absolutely.
And
then I think that was cool too, is that at the beginning I was introduced to some really influential people within the town, and it wasn't just a one-time introduction. They've been, anything that I can help with them or they're helping with me, for the last almost 3 years, we've been doing something, with these people. So that's sort of, it's pretty cool to see them always thinking of us, hey, there's an opportunity for this. Do you want to join us on this one? And if I can't, it's no hard feelings at all. Yeah. They're like, no, we'll get you next time. From the hair salon around the corner to the Children's Foundation. It's like all these different outlets that that I think make up, what this town is all about. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah. Very cool. Awesome.
Cool.
Jeff, I want to thank you again.
I appreciate you coming in.
We'll have to keep on doing this. And
have fun. Let's see how the spring goes and the summer goes. Get you here for an event.
Okay. Sounds good. Thank you.